Hi dears, welcome you all to the part 4 of the lesson Periodic Table. Do you remember what we learned in the last class? Absolutely, it's about periodic table. So last day we learnt about how to find the groups and periods of elements in the periodic table using electronic configurations, right? So today we are going to learn about the different families on the periodic table and their common characteristics. As you know, according to modern periodic law, the physical and chemical properties of elements are the periodic functions of their atomic number. In modern periodic table, there are 18 groups and 7 periods. The horizontal rows in a periodic table are called periods, and the vertical columns in the periodic table are groups. So based on the common characteristics of elements in each group, they can be grouped as a different families. So shall we begin? In the periodic table, the elements in the middle are called transition elements. Others are main group elements. Among these, 4 groups have commonly used names. That is, first group, alkali metals. Second group, alkaline earth metals. Group 17, halogen family. And group 18, noble gases. So let's get familiar with each families. Group 1 elements. The first group elements in the periodic table are called alkali metals. These elements include lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, and francium. If you observe the electronic configuration of these group elements, you can see that the number of electrons present in the outermost shell will be 1. Do you know why these elements are known by this name? Group 1 elements form alkaline solution when they react with water. Hence, it got the name. Remember, group 1 elements are highly reactive. They react vigorously with water. The second group elements in the periodic table are called alkaline earth metals. It includes beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, and radium. These group elements forms oxides, which are alkaline in nature, and they occur in the earth crust. They are reactive but less reactive than alkali metals. Next family is a very important one in the periodic table. The group 3 to 12 elements in the periodic table are called transition elements. They show a transition character from metals to non-metals. Let's get familiar with the properties of these elements. Generally, all the transition elements are metals. They form colored compounds. Moreover, they show similarities in the chemical properties in groups as well as in periods. In the beginning, I told you 4 groups in the periodic table are known by the common name. The elements in the group 1 and 2 and those in groups 13 to 18 of periodic table are generally known as representative elements. This representative elements form mostly all the compounds in the nature. It include metals, nonmetals, and metalloids. Now observe the periodic table closely. The majority of the elements in the periodic table are metals. They occupy the entire left and center of the periodic table. Nonmetals present on the upper right hand corner of the periodic table. The colors showing green, yellow, orange are the nonmetals. There are certain other elements which shows both the characteristics of metals and nonmetals. These are called metalloids. The metalloids are located along the staircase in between metals and nonmetals. Some metalloids like silicon, germanium, arsenic, etc. act as a semiconductors. Next one is a very familiar group, group 18 elements. The elements helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon and radon of group 18 in the periodic table are noble gases. Do you remember the peculiarity of electronic configuration of these elements? All noble gases have 8 electrons in their valence shell, right? Normally, these gases do not participate with other elements. Hence, they are called inert gases. So, let's familiar with the uses of noble gases. Helium is used for filling weather balloons as it has very low density. Neon gas. Neon is used in the discharge lamps as it has an orange color. Argon. It is filled in the electric bulb to prevent evaporation of filament. So last one is radon. Radon is a radioactive gas and it is found only in very small quantities. So these are the uses of noble gases. So shall we move to the next? Students, have you seen the two series placed on the bottom of periodic table? They are called inert transition elements. Period 6 and period 7 are called inert transition elements. The inert transition elements from lanthanum to lutetium of period 6 are called lanthanides. These lanthanides are also known as rare earth. Similarly, inner transition elements from actinium to lawrencium of period 7 are called actinoids. The actinoids after uranium are artificial. Alright students, so hope you got an overall idea about the families on the periodic table. So let's meet you in the next class. Thank you.